This video is part 2 of the Aquifer in a Cup series. If you have not watched part 1, then go do that now. In this video, we will be creating our very own aquifer to model what the Memphis aquifer looks like. Normally, we would use materials like gravel, clay, and sand, because that is what makes up the aquifer's layers in real life. To make this lesson more interesting, we will instead be using materials that you can find in your own home. Before we begin, we need to gather all of our materials. First, you should find a clean, flat surface to build the aquifer on. Next, you will need a small cup that is see-through. This is what we will build the aquifer in. To represent sand and gravel, I will be using crushed ice. You could also use crushed cookies or crackers. To create groundwater, I will be using a clear soda like Sprite. You could also use any other kind of soda or just water. Oreos will be used to create a layer of soil on the top. Ice cream will represent our clay layer because it's dense and thick. We will also need a straw to represent a well, and food coloring to represent pollution. Now that we have all of our materials together, we can begin to build the aquifer. Let's first place the cup in the center of our workstation. The first thing to put into the cup is the crushed ice. That's our sandy aquifer. Then, we will pour a small amount of soda into the cup. Do you notice how the soda takes up space in between the pieces of ice? This is similar to how water takes up space in between sand particles. Now let's take a scoop of ice cream and pack it tightly into the cup on top of the ice-soda mixture. This layer simulates how clay is packed tightly on top of the sandy layer, which protects the groundwater from contamination. Make sure that your ice cream is covering the entire space with no gaps. Now, let's add one more layer of crushed ice or cookies to represent the gravel layer that's on top. Then, we're going to take our food coloring and put just a few drops into the cup on top of the gravel. What do you notice happening? Do you see how the food coloring flows through the gravel quickly, but stays on top of the clay layer and doesn't reach the groundwater? This is how the real aquifer works as well. But what if we created a breach, or a gap, in the thick layer of ice cream? What do you think would happen? Let's test it. Take your straw and push it into your cup, all the way through every layer. This straw represents how a well would be drilled into the aquifer. We drill wells into the aquifer in order to get the water out and to use it. Breaches in real life aren't made by humans, but this helps demonstrate how it happens. So now that there is a breach in the clay, or ice cream, the food coloring is able to travel down into the deeper layers. This is a problem because when pollutants in real life enter a breach in the clay layer, our aquifer can become contaminated. This is why it's important for everyone to protect the aquifer by keeping trash and pollutants like oil or fertilizers away from our waterways. Now put your straw back into your cup and take a big sip. You might have to try hard to clear out the ice cream. Did you drink most of the soda? That means the aquifer is almost empty, so we need to recharge it. How does that happen? Rain. So get your soda and pour a little more into your cup. Watch how it takes some time for the soda to infiltrate past the ice cream. The more water we use, the less that we have for the future. It's important to conserve water by taking shorter showers, turning off the taps when you're brushing your teeth, and in many more ways. Now that you have finished building the aquifer, feel free to eat it. You might need a spoon now. While enjoying your tasty aquifer treat, please complete this post-video questionnaire. I hope you enjoyed our activity today. For more videos or to learn more about Caesar, go to our website that's shown below. Thank you for learning with me.